problem is people aren't fully aware or fully conscious of what their body or their mind is experiencing, right? Whether it's positive or negative. And that's shit, especially on the positive side, you know, because if not experiencing fully the positive place that they're in, then that's crap. But again, on the equal side, if they're experiencing they're having a bad experience, or something that's causing them to be less content than what they should be. I'm trying to avoid like happy and positive, less content than what they could be, but they can't see that. That's only because they're not used to scratching below the surface of what the conscious is, right? And it sounds all fluffy. No, it's just an art we've forgotten. That's all it is. It's an art we've forgotten, especially for the last 10, 15 years, is being comfortable in our own minds. I'd argue that before the advent of smartphones and technology and internet, 15, 20 years ago, people were much more in touch with their mind and their body and much more content simply because they had the opportunity to sit at a bus stop waiting with nothing else to do but sit at a bus stop waiting and thinking about the events that have just happened, thinking about experiences, thinking about the emotions that they feel, thinking about what they're going to do later on, not being consumed by what's on their phone, for example. We just had that. There was always time to focus on you and think about what's going on. You didn't think about it like that at the time because it wasn't thought about that. You're just sitting there passing the time in your own mind. You try getting a kid to do that these days. You try getting most adults to do that these days. After 2 minutes, after 60 seconds maybe, they're going to be one in their phone. Put it next to them. They're going to be one in their phone. They're going to want to stand up and walk about. They're going to want to ring someone. They're just not comfortable with it. It's an art we've lost. And we need to pull ourselves, I genuinely believe, we need to pull ourselves back to it. You know, and what we're talking about now with the sort of the psychedelic experiences, this is like just a couple of levels up in sort of understanding or experience what lies in our minds, what is there to expose, and what can you benefit from it.